Good morning, children. Now, this is the 13th lesson in 7th class social studies. What is the 13th lesson? The Kings of Vijayanagara. Okay, the Kings of Vijayanagara. In the previous lesson, I said about Kakatiya Kingdom, which were ruled in the place of Warangal. Okay, that means Telangana region from Warangal. Warangal was there. Capital. Okay, so they are various, or they are chiefs. So they created or they announced that place as one kingdom and they ruled. They appointed some various as chiefs. Okay, for with the help of these chiefs, they ruled the kingdom, which Kakatiya kingdom. So likewise, here also the same one. So after Kakatiyas, okay, so in Karnataka region also, we can see another powerful kingdom that is called Vijayanagara Kingdom. What is that kingdom? Vijayanagara Kingdom. So, Vijayanagara Kingdom established on the bank of Tungabhadra River. Where? Tungabhadra River in Karnataka. So, Karnataka is now one of the state. Okay, back of our Andhra Pradesh. So we can see the Karnataka state back of our Andhra Pradesh, the west side of Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so the Tungabhadra River bank, they established this kingdom. What is that kingdom name? Vijayanagara. What is that? Vijayanagara. So who were the founders of this Vijayanagara? Here two brothers established this Vijayanagara kingdom. The two brothers' names are here. Harihara Raya, Bukka Raya. What are the two brothers? Harihara Raya, Bukka Raya. So these two brothers came from Sangama dynasty. What is that dynasty name? Sangama dynasty. So when they established this kingdom, 1336 AD. Vijayanagara kingdom was established by two brothers, Harihara Raya and Bukka Raya, with the blessings of one sage. His name was here Vidyaranya. What is his name? Vidyaranya. So Vidyaranya blessed these two brothers to establish the kingdom of Vijayanagara. So that is why they started this kingdom. Okay, next one. They worshipped Sri Virupaksha. Virupaksha is their god. Okay? So Virupaksha means here Shiva. That is why they built on the hill of that area Shiva temples. Okay? Why? Because they worshipped Shiva. Shiva on those days called Sri Virupaksha. So Virupaksha temple was built by Vijayanagara kings. Are in the kingdom. Next one, children, they ruled 250 years. How many years? 250 years. Not only that, these two brothers founded, that means they started this kingdom after this dynasty. What is that dynasty? Sangama dynasty. So Sangama dynasty after Saluva dynasty came. That means Saluva kings came as Vijayanagara king. After Saluva, Tuluva dynasty came. After Tuluva, Aravitti dynasty came. So these are the four dynasties ruled Vijayanagara kingdom. How many years? 250 years. 250 years. Founders are Harihara Raya, Bukka Raya. Next to students here, at the same another kingdom also started, that is Bahmani kingdom. What is that kingdom? Bahmani kingdom. But the Bahmani kingdom capital is Gulbarga. Okay. Bahmani kingdom capital is Gulbarga. But this capital later divided as, after decline of this kingdom, that all region divided as small kingdoms. How many? Five small kingdoms. Among them here, Bijapur, Golconda. these are the two small kingdoms are important, Bijapur kingdom and Golconda kingdom. So actually these are Muslims, okay, from where they came and settled here in India. They came from Iran and Arabia. So they are Muslims. They came from Iran and Arabia. They started kingdom, that is Bahmani kingdom, with the capital of Gulbarga. After this after this kingdom declined, that all region divided as or created as five small kingdoms, among them Bijapur and Golconda is important. Next to here, how can we know or how do we know about these Vijayanagara kingdom and Bahmani kingdom or Golconda and Bijapur kingdom? So how can I say? Because we have some things or we have some evidence. What are that evidence here? Books are there. Inscriptions are there. Inscriptions means Shasanamulu. They wrote on the stone tablets or stone tablets. Okay. So on that stone, they wrote about their history. Okay. If they want to build any temple, okay, after completion of this temple, they wrote about who built this temple, okay, how much duration taken place, etc. Next to buildings, they built many buildings. So when we, the archaeologists found many buildings in their excavations around Tungabhadra region. So when archaeologists excavating, so they found about buildings of these Vijayanagara kings. Next to some books also there. Okay. Next one, what is the next evidence here? Some travelers came and visited our country at the time of Vijayanagara kings. Okay, who are the travelers here? Niccolo Conti, one of the traveler. So he visited, actually he came from Italy. Italy is one of the country in Europe. Okay, so in 1420 AD he came and visited the Vijayanagara kingdom. After Abdul Razak also came from Persia. Persia means now Iran, back of our India. The west side of India, we can find Pakistan. After Pakistan, Afghanistan. After Iran, Iraq, etc. So, Iran is also known as Persia. What is that? Persia. So, here Abdul Razak came from Persia. So, he said about this Vijayanagara kingdom, okay, that all kingdom, okay, fortification, seven rings are there. How many rings? Seven rings. That means they built wall around the tall city for the protection of the enemies. That is very made by strong stones. Okay. That all walls and towers also there. So they build strong walls and towers. Okay. For the protection of that Vijayanagara kingdom. Okay, so it was described by Abdul Razak. He is one of the traveler from Persia. Next, Domingo Piaz. He is also Portuguese. He came from Portugal. Portugal people called Portuguese. India people called Indians, like that. So he came, what his name? Domingo Piaz. So he said the city construction very beautiful, and also they built around this city a strong walls and towers. Even inside of the city also, a clean straight rows also there. Okay? The merchants, they are selling valuable things in the streets. What are the valuable things here? Diamonds, emeralds, pearls, okay, cloths, etc. Not only these diamonds, emeralds, pearls, rubies, cloths, etc. In evening time, they will sell horses, vegetables, some kinds of fruits, etc. in evening time. So once you imagine, children, how this country is rich, because they are selling diamonds, rubies, emeralds, horses, etc. Okay, next one. Listen, children. They are maintaining military power. So the king hold some military power. What is the use of this military? Cavalry. Cavalry means horse riders. Okay. They appointed many soldiers to protect the country from enemies. Okay. Next one. They imported these powerful or strong horses from Iran. What is that? Iran. They recruited not only our local citizen, but also they recruited Muslims. Who? Muslims. Because Muslims, they know the warfare, how to ride the horse, how to fight against the enemies, etc. So the kings of Vijayanagara, they encouraged to build mosques in that area. Why? Because they recruited Muslims. So we know Muslims who going to mosques. For example, Christians going to church, Hindus going to temples, etc. That means they are encouraged to construct these mosques in that kingdom. Next one, they imported or they introduced guns, cannons also in their country. Okay, so these all are happening in Vijayanagara kingdom. Next one, they appointed captains. So many troops are there. So each captain have some members. These are looking after the villages and towns. Okay, they will collect tax from villages, towns, and who are the traders, etc. Okay, so next one, kings appointing captains. These captains are called Amaranayaka. What they are called? Amaranayakas. Okay, so here Piyas, he visited Vijayanagara kingdom during the time of Krishnadevaraya. So he wrote in his book about to Krishnadevaraya time, how the kingdom was. It was very powerful. Actually, Krishnadevaraya was fearful man, fearful king. Okay, so he appointed many army. This army, whenever the kings will order, immediately they will ready to fight against to enemies. So that is the powerful army which is maintained by Krishnadevaraya. It was described by the Domingo Piyas. What is his name? Domingo Piyas. Next one, they encouraged, these all various are encouraged Telugu literature or Telugu language. Okay, Telugu language. Even the various, that means captains, among them, important captains here, Salva Narasimha, Narasa Nayaka. These are the important captains in this troop. Many captains are there. They are maintaining troops or soldiers. Next, they are collecting tax from the village people and town people. Next one, our merchants also. Because merchants are selling valuable things. Diamonds, rubies, emeralds, etc. Evening time, they will sell horses, vegetables, fruits, etc. Next one, they said about Vijayanagara kingdom. So it divided as four main parts. The first part is temple area, which is built over hills. Second part is palaces, king's residence and nobles' residence or captain's residence. Another part is merchant area. Another part is, the fourth part is ordinary people living area. So that all area divided as four types or four parts. First part is temple spot. Second part is king's residence area. Third part is Nayakas, etc. area. Merchants area. The fourth part is, the fourth residence is, our area is ordinary people, town folk area. So that is about Vijayanagara kingdom. Okay students, I want to show you some pictures in this lesson. Once look at here.
Look, these statues, bronze statues are images Krishna Devaraya and his two wives installed in Tirumala temple. Okay, now this is there. Next, you turn your pages in this same lesson, page number 117. Look at this is their kingdom. So how they fortified these all. Look at this is temple area. This is Tungabhadra river. Okay, this is fort. Okay, next this is mosque. So this is the area of Vijayanagara kingdom. Okay children, I shall explain to you the remaining part in the next class. Thank you.